once we hired Blake, once we actually jumped into it, we actually created a music cue sheet for you too, outlining our whole film and where we thought cues belonged. Helen, our associate editor back there, she created that for us. And I don't know how much you used it, but it was really nerdy of us. But we had sort of it all outlined on where we saw music going and sort of what that mood might be. And if there was a temp track in there, I think there was even a link to it. So that was super nerdy and organized. But I don't know, you can tell us if you used that or not.
That was great.
Okay.
Very, because I didn't have a music editor, or I was just, you know, it helped me go through it. But also the first meeting, we just kind of got to know each other. We spent like a 2-hour lunch, because it's really important to know, for you guys to know, I mean, is this guy too freaking weird for us to be in a room with him for the next 2 months? And do we like these? Do we all like each other?
Well, and we were making a documentary about something that was very important to us, and we knew would be very important to part of the world, at least. And so Blake's passion sold us a lot, too, on the issue. I mean, he's not even gay, you know? His wife is right here. And we just assumed he was gay because he sent us an email right away saying, I have to do this film. And he wasn't
gay. For a long time.
A lot of people just assume I'm gay. A lot of people.
Yeah, it took us like an hour to the lunch to figure out when he said the word wife, and we were like, wow, he just became more interesting to us. But find someone, I think, who is so passionate about the message of your film, because Blake has worked his ass off for not enough money and has worked around the clock, and I know he's worked way harder than what we paid him for, and I think that's because he really believed in the message of the film, and it's been really amazing to actually get to show the film and watch people react to the music.